इंटेंसिव प्रॉपर्टीज। दोज प्रॉपर्टीज प्रॉपर्टीज विच डज नॉट गेट डिवाइडेड ऑन डिवाइड। फॉर एग्जाम्पल इफ वी टेक रिफ्रैक्टिव इंडेक्स, रिफ्रैक्टिव इंडेक्स, रिफ्रैक्टिव इंडेक्स, रिफ्रैक्टिव इंडेक्स फॉर ग्लास इज 1.5। रिफ्रैक्टिव इंडेक्स फॉर ग्लास इज 1.5। इफ यू टेक अ वेरी बिग ग्लास शीट एंड यू ब्रेक इट इनटू पीसेस, देन एवरी पीस विल हैव सेम रिफ्रैक्टिव इंडेक्स। Every piece of glass will have same refractive index. So it is extensive property or intensive property? It is extensive property or intensive property? On dividing the substance, refractive index is not getting divided. It is extensive property or intensive property? Intensive property. Sanika, you didn't get it?
Yes, sir, got it.
Sir, can you please scroll up?
What about others? So those properties which get divided on dividing the substance are extensive properties, which does not get divided are intensive properties. All of you understood? All of you understood?
Can you please explain what do you mean by properties that divide and don't divide?
Well, I took an example of glass, right? If you take a sheet of glass, its refractive index is 1.5. That is its property, if you know about refractive index. Do we know what is refractive index?
Yes, sir.
Right? Refraction ke andar padhte hain, right? So that property of glass will not get divided. If you break your glass into 100 pieces, your refractive index of glass will not become 1.5 divided by 100. It will remain 1.5. Yes. So those properties which does not get divided on dividing a substance are called intensive properties, and which get divided are extensive properties. Now take these examples also. Volume and mass. I have taken three examples till now. Any problem in these examples? Any problem in these examples?
No, sir.
Okay. Then tell me about temperature. Extensive or intensive?
Intensive.
Intensive. Tell me about pressure. Extensive or intensive? Pressure. Pressure, Sakshi. Intensive. Any problem to anyone in any of them? Can you tell me molarity? Molarity, Sanjana. Molarity, Sanjana. Vedant. Sanjana.
Intensive.
Vedan.
It is intensive.
Intensive. Why it is intensive?
Sir, does not depend
because
on
because it is a ratio. Mass.
Very good. Who said it's ratio? What's your name?
Sir Sanika.
But you have mentioned extensive here, I think. No, intensive only. Very good, Sanika. Okay, ratio. But till now I have taught that if it does not get divided on dividing, can you explain me on that basis? Take a solution.
So will it be that if we take the ratio of two extensive properties, or it will be intensive?
Definitely, Sanika, you can say that. If you remember that from the first chapter, it is very good. But abhi maine wo nahi bataya. I told you this in the first chapter, concentration terms.
Yes.
Wahan par maine aapko ye bataya tha. But now I have not, abhi maine aapko ye cheez nahi batai hai. So can we explain this on the basis of that? Divided and dividing, are you getting it through that also? That's what I'm asking.
Throughout the solution.
See, I have 500 ml solution, which is 5 m molar. Okay? The concentration of the solution is 5 m molar. If I take even a drop of this, a drop of this solution, that will also be 5 molar. This is called does not get divided on dividing. This is called does not get divided on dividing. Yes, we are not talking about moles. We are talking about moles per unit volume. Molarity moles nahi hota hai. Molarity hota hai moles per unit volume. Whatever moles you will be having, respective volume you will also be having. You will be having such the volume that your concentration will remain 5 m. Sanika understood by this method? Yes, very good. Yes, you understood this, what you are saying? But as the volume decreases, won't it affect molarity? Dekho. Yes, if I have 50 mole and 10 liter, what will be the molarity? Yes. Yeah, because you are saying that moles will decrease. So this will be 5 m. Now I have only 1 ml. And I have 5 into 10 to the raised power minus 3 mole. What will be the molarity? Yes. So what will be the molarity? Yes, sir, 5. Right? Understood? So agar aap volume decrease karoge, sorry, if you decrease the moles, your volume will also decreases. Overall, your concentration will remain same. Molarity will remain same, whatever, no matter what amount of solution you take. Very good, Tanmay. That's what I'm talking about. Very good, Sanika. We will come to that. We will talk about all the concentration terms, Sanika. Amount of mass is nothing, yaar. Ye to koi word hi nahi ban raha hai. Aradhya. You should say amount of substance, right? Amount of substance bolo, that will be correct. Understood? Yes. Amount of matter. So now if I just jump to molality, will it make any change if I ask you molality? Extensive or intensive?
Intensive, sir.
Intensive. Why? This is also a conservation term. This is also a conservation term. No difference. All concentration terms are intensive. If you remember, I told you in the first chapter, all concentration terms are intensive. Okay, yes. All concentration terms are intensive. Now, if I ask you, 10%, sorry, percentage W by V, extensive or intensive? Percentage W by V, extensive or intensive? Percentage W by V, very good, yes.
Intensive.
You can simply say, extension term hai, hence it will be intensive. Now tell me mole fraction. Sanika, what you were saying about mole fraction? Intensive. Why? Because this is also a concentration term.
Yeah.
Concentration term ka matlab, we are talking about the solution. We are talking about the thickness of the solution. Thickness will always remain same. Understood. Understood. If I ask you viscosity. Viscosity.
Excuse me, sir.
Yes.
Can you just scroll up? I have just joined. So, intensive.
Very good. Whatever amount of honey you take, the thickness you can see will remain the same. Done, Sania. Boiling point. Boiling point. Tanme.
Intensive.
Very good. Sanika. Sanjana, understood. What will be boiling point? Boiling point kya hoga? Boiling point intensive. Kyun? When I say boiling point of water, I never mention the amount. Jab main bolta hu ki boiling point of water 100 degree centigrade hai, I never mention the amount ki yaar 500 ml ke liye 100 degree centigrade hoga. Boiling point of water depends upon the intermolecular interaction. Kitni zyada strong forces hai. It will not depend upon ki wo zyada amount hai ya kam amount hai. So boiling point will be intense. Very good, Tanmay. Any doubt to anyone in this? Okay, can I also write vapor pressure, surface tension, intensive? Can I write this also? Can I write this yes. also? Okay. Ab batao density. Density.
Intensive.
What you are saying? You are saying that ratio of two extensive properties is always intensive, right? So this also yes. we can remember. ये हो जाएगा हमारा मास पर यूनिट वॉल्यूम. जस्ट वेट फॉर अ मिनट. यस मैम. यस मैम. मैम आई एम इन क्लास. क्लास. हाँ क्लास.
So could you please scroll up a bit?
Yes. Any problem to anyone till here?
Yes.
Any problem to anyone till here? Okay. Now, who was saying about heat capacity? हीट कैपेसिटी के बारे में कौन बता रहा था? तन्मय, राइट? व्हाट इज हीट कैपेसिटी? हीट कैपेसिटी क्या है? इट इज देयर इन नाइन्थ क्लास और एट्थ क्लास.
अमाउंट ऑफ हीट व्हिच इज सप्लाइड फॉर अ पर्टिकुलर मटेरियल
फॉर व्हाट पर्पस?
पर्पस होगा ना कुछ.
So heat capacity is the amount of heat required to raise the temperature of the substance by 1 degree. Heat capacity is the amount of heat required to raise the temperature of the substance by 1 degree. Now tell me, if you have this substance, and this substance, and this substance, in which case you have to apply more heat to raise the temperature of the substance by 1 degree? Consider them as wooden blocks. A, B, C. You want me to repeat the definition?
Yes, sir.
Amount of heat required. Amount of heat required to raise the temperature of the substance by 1 degree.
Yes, sir.
Now tell me, in which case you think maximum heat will be required to raise the temperature by 1 degree? 1 degree heat karne ke liye maximum heat kisko dena padega? A, B, C, D. D. Any doubt to anyone in D? Any doubt to anyone in D? Any doubt to anyone in D? Okay, now tell me whether it is extensive property or intensive property. Very good, Sanika. So heat capacity is an extensive property. Heat capacity is extensive property. Heat capacity is extensive property. heat capacity is extensive property. Okay. Can anyone tell me what is specific heat capacity? Specific heat capacity. Can anyone tell what is specific heat capacity? Specific heat capacity. Specific heat is amount of heat required to raise.
Yo, what is it cracking?
Is it cracking, sir?
Hello. Is it audible now?
Is it cracking, sir?
It's cracking. Till now it was clear, right? I'll just rejoin then. Hello. Am I audible now?
Yes.
The amount of heat required to raise the temperature of the substance, 1 gram of substance by 1 degree. What do you think? It's extensive or intensive? Extensive or intensive? Tanika, force kisi substance ki property nahi hai. फोर्स इज जस्ट अ पुश और पुल दैट यू अप्लाई है ना, किसी सब्सटेंस की प्रॉपर्टी नहीं है.
गॉट इट.
बताओ स्पेसिफिक हीट कैपेसिटी क्या होगा.
सो एक्सटेंसिव.
व्हाई कैन वी वेरी द मास हियर. Can we vary the mass here? क्या हम यहाँ पर मास को चेंज कर सकते हैं? Can we change the mass here? No. Whatever substance you take, I will talk about 1 gram only. I will talk about 1 gram only. And hence, it will remain same. Understood. So this is specifically for 1 gram. It cannot be changed. Hence it is intensive. Hence it is intensive.
So explain again.
I said that here we will talk about 1 gram of substance. We cannot change the mass of the substance. When we cannot change the mass of the substance, it will not depend upon the mass of the substance. Yes or no?
Yes.
If you take a bigger wooden block or you take a smaller wooden block, you just have to talk about 1 gram of that. So it doesn't matter whether it is big or small. For 1 gram, same amount of energy will be required. Unless, until your block is same. Understood? If you have wooden block, one yes. is big, one is small. But we want to talk only about 1 gram of that. So it will remain same. The heat required will be same. Hence, it will be intensive property.
Yes, I got it. Thank you, sir.
Understood, all of you? So I can give you a hint. Kisi bhi property ke aage agar specific lag jata hai. Whatever property you have, if they have a specific word before it, it becomes intensive. Any property which have specific word will be intensive. Jaise specific volume. Specific volume. This will be intensive. Understood? Understood, all of you?
Yes.
Any problem to anyone? Any problem to anyone? Internal energy. Enthalpy, entropy gives free energy. All are extensive properties. Copy it fast. All are extensive properties. You do not know any one of them, but it will come in this chapter only. And we have a different topics for this. Okay, so do not need to know. अभी उनको समझने की जरूरत नहीं है. When they will come, I'll tell you. As of now, just remember this. All these properties are important and all of them are extensive properties. They will come in this chapter only. Okay.
All of them depend on mass, right?
All of them depends upon somehow on mass only, yes. All of you understood? So now we have types of processes. Types of processes. Types of processes. Types of processes. Please mute your mic. This we will do in the next class, as 30 students are not there because of that internet issue. So abhi itna karte hain. Rest we'll do in the next class. Thank you.
Thank you, sir.
Thank you, sir. Thank you, sir.